What's up, guys? DJ ESG Honest Wedding Advice, season number 10. And today I'm talking about scheduling your wedding on top of a sporting event. Listen, I'm from Philly. I bleed green. There's nothing better in this world than the Philadelphia Eagles. I got the Sixers, I got the Flyers, I got the Phillies. There's nothing bigger in my world, in this world, in the world of DJ ESG than the Philadelphia Eagles. End of story. So if you're going to schedule your big day on a Sunday in the middle of September through December, or even February, God help me, or January during the playoffs, you got to remember something. There's a strong chance that there's going to be a game on during that wedding. Now, a lot of people like myself, listen, I'm going to still do weddings. You know what I mean? Like, I'm going to figure it out later. I'll watch the replay. I'll listen in. You know, it's not going to stop me from doing what I got to do because I love weddings just as much as I love the Eagles. They're right there. You know, wife, animals, family, wedding, Eagles. They're all right there. You know what I mean? So you look at it from this perspective. People are going to stare at their phones. They're going to look at televisions. They're not going to be paying full attention. As long as that game is going on during your wedding, there's going to be people that are going to be tapped out of your wedding. It is what it is. You know what I mean? When you schedule the wedding and you say, oh, listen, you know, this is a Sunday and everything's great and it's cheaper and the venue's giving it to me for this and that. And all of a sudden you find out Dallas is playing Philly in Philly. That's coming up in a few weeks. I got to deal with that. I don't know how happy the groom is, but I'm sure people that are coming to the wedding are going to be like, yo, yeah, we're going to have the phone on the table, this, that, and the other thing. Listen, people are still going to have a good time. They're still going to party, but you got to understand that it's going to happen. It's going to take some people away from what's going on at that actual event. You know, I'm not here to sugarcoat and tell you a story. I'm here to tell you the truth. This is honest wedding advice. This is not tell you what you want to hear wedding advice. This is the fucking truth. So I had a party this past weekend. It was a kiddie trunk or treat, right? And you got to think, parents are there with their kids and their wives. Now, what happened as soon as the game started at 1 o'clock? Because the trunk or treat ran from 12 to 3 yesterday. Well, they turned on the TV in the bar area, and everybody was out there watching the game. So my room where I had the trunk or treat was, like, empty. There was kids there. We played Disney songs. They were the young kids. They danced around. They had fun. You know, I smiled. I waved and all that jazz. But I'm sitting there watching the TV through the doorway because everybody else was watching the TV and what was going on. So, you know, it took all the dads, some of the moms, away from what was going on in the main room. And the kids are running around endlessly in circles while the parents are watching the game. And if that's families, if that's dads, if that's parents, got to imagine what you're going to get at a wedding. It is what it is. You know what I mean? Like, you're not going to change that. So if you schedule your wedding on a Sunday or even, like, you know, let's say a Saturday night and the Phillies, could happen, you know, right now we have the Yankees playing the Dodgers, but you know, and all of a sudden there's a championship game on it. Be prepared to have to figure out a way to get those people, or just to allow those people to watch their phones. Maybe there's even a spot to have a television they can actually watch the TV. I've had people bring a TV before, set it up in front of the DJ booth, so while they're dancing and looking at the TV, they're looking at me. It happened. It was a great time. We had fun. I didn't see it. The TV was backed up to me and I was playing it, but it is what it is. You know, you got to kind of go with the flow of certain things that are going to happen. You know, I mean, it just, you know, it's life. So in that life, you have to pivot. And much like other things in life, you know, when you have a baby or somebody in your family gets a, you know, rare terminal disease, or you get into a car crash or you lose your job, you have to pivot. So be prepared to pivot when you have your event and the big sporting event is on that day, especially something, you know, that includes your hometown team. You know, it's just, it's good advice. It's you know, it's better than good. It's great advice. You know what I mean? And we got a winning record. We're getting there. So, you know, we're not Washington Commanders getting there yet this season, but we're getting there. So I'm DJ ESG. This is Honest Wedding Advice. Peace, love, and God above, and I'll be back. Bye-bye.